Okay, now that we have training data and test data, let's go ahead and build a model. So I'm going to do an all model to start with, and you'll see what I mean in a minute. So all I do to make the model is call the constructor for linear regression models, which I imported from sklearn before. And if you print it, it's just an object. So just prints as a linear regression object. But then you can fit the model. So let's do all model.fit. And then this is going to fit a set of independent variable values to a set of dependent variable values. And if you do shift tab, it will show you the arguments. Basically, it just takes a set of X variables and a set of Y variables, and then an optional sample weight, which we're going to ignore. So for the dependent variables, we're going to start with our iris train data, but we only want the input bars columns. So I'm passing, this is an array of column names that I'm passing into iris train, which is a pandas data frame. And this is going to give me just those columns. And then for my dependent variables, that's going to be iris train output bars. Okay, so what this is going to do is it's going to internally adjust this model to find the best line through these input vars in order to predict the output vars. And then what can we look at? So let's look at what it's going to give us is a set of coefficients and a set of intercepts. And I'll talk about that after we get some values out. So let's display all model dot coefficients underscore and display all model dot intercept underscore. Okay, so what this did was it basically made three linear regression models, and this is the first model. It has this set of four coefficients, and then it has one intercept. So four coefficients and one intercept for one model, and then another four set of coefficients and another intercept for a second model, and another set of four coefficients and another intercept for a third model. And what those map to is you take for a particular iris, like this first row here, you take the sepal length and you multiply it by this first coefficient here. And then you take the sepal width and you multiply it by this coefficient and add these together. And then you take the third one, which is petal length, and you multiply it by this coefficient and add that to the total. And then you take petal width and you multiply it by this coefficient and you add all those together. Then you add up this intercept. And then that number should come really close to this value here. So that's the first linear regression model, is you multiply these things by the coefficients and add them together. Then you add the intercept and it should give you a number that's roughly close to either this zero or this one. So that times that times coefficient plus that times coefficient and so on should be zero. And this times the coefficient plus this times the coefficient plus this times and plus the intercept should be roughly equal to one. And that's the first model. And then you do the second thing with the second set of coefficients and the second intercept. And that should give you a number that's pretty close to this zero or one. And then you do the third set of coefficients and the third intercept, and that should give you a number that's pretty close to this zero or one here. So that's what the three models are doing. So let's actually work one of these by hand just so that we can see what it's doing. So I'm going to copy this row here, and really could be any row of data, and we'll look at that in a minute as well. And so I'm just going to paste this in as a comment. Tabs are weird. So let's do 6.1 times 0.04588534 plus 2.8 times 0.26240911 plus, and then the third number was 4.7 times minus 0.21414513. Doing stuff by hand is dumb and slow. And then the fourth number is 1.2 times minus 0.05954 84. Okay, plus this first intercept, which is 0.13188164. And that value is 0.068, which is pretty close to zero. So our prediction for the first value is zero, and that's pretty close. And then let's do the same thing here. So this one's 5.7, 3.8, 1.7, 0.3. That should be pretty close to 1. So we'll do that. So 5.7 and 3.8 and 1.7 and 0.3. And then this value should be pretty close to 1, and it's 1.008. Okay, so that's how the linear regression works. I have a set of coefficients, I multiply them by the four independent variables, and I add the intercept, and that should give me a value that's pretty close to the dependent variable. And then if you do that for all three of them, you get all three of these x, y, and z's. So now that we understand what the math is doing, there's a built-in method that makes it easy to do that for an entire data set. So what I can do is I can take my all model and call the predict method on this. And then I pass it a set of cases that I want to make predictions on. And I could pass it either the training data or the test data. So let's do iris test. And then I want the input vars from iris test. And what this is going to do is it's going to give me the predicted values for the output variables. And since there are three output variables for species setosa, species versicolor, and species virginica, I get three values for each of the irises in the training data. So this one, for example, we see that, well, this one's probably versicolor, because definitely not setosa, and unlikely that it's virginica. This one is almost definitely setosa, and almost definitely not versicolor or virginica. This one is probably virginica, but this is pretty high for setosa. It's hard to do a good job of classifying setosas. This is probably not setosa. Maybe it's virginica, maybe it's versicolor. This one's definitely not setosa, but maybe it's probably versicolor, maybe it's virginica. This one's definitely setosa, and so on. So it's doing a really easy, doing a good job probably of classifying the setosa, as would expect, basically any number over 0.5 is probably Setosa, and any number less than 0.5 is probably not Setosa. But as you see, there's a fair degree of overlap between the Virginica values and the Versacolor values. Now, what we can do, though, is we can actually take this data and we can add it to our original test data, which includes the actual species Setosa, species Virginica, and species Versacolor, and do comparisons of the predicted versus the actual values. And so the way you do that is basically you take these predictions and turn them into a data frame, and then you join that data frame with the original test data. So to make this be a data frame, I'm going to say predictions, I'll call it all predicts, because this is my all model, is going to be pd.dataframe. And then for the data, I'm going to pass in just this array here. And then this is an array of three columns, and so I have to give it three column names. So the columns is going to be a list of, first thing is predicted Setosa, and then predicted Versacolor, and then predicted Virginica. So that should give me a data frame. Oh, and it should be columns equals that. Okay, so here's a data frame with my predictions in it. And then these are going to be in exactly the same order as the cases in my test set. So all I need to do is just get rid of the index on my test set. Let's look at the test data. So this is iris test. And actually doesn't have an index. What it has for the index is a sequence number for each iris. But the order is the same here as the order for all predict. So what I want to do is drop this index from my test data and then join the result to all predict. So all predict dot join with iris data. And then I'm also going to drop any values that weren't explicitly included in the set. So that will give me a new, okay. So what I want to do here is get rid of the index and then drop here. Okay. So anything that's not in the index is going to get dropped. All right. So here's my data frame. It has my predicted values and it has my actual values. And then I can calculate the difference between the predicted and the actual just by doing subtraction. So, for example, if I take the predicted versus the actual for species Setosa, let's go ahead and set all predict equal to that data frame. And then I can print all predict sub predicted Setosa versus all predict sub species Setosa. And then numbers close to zero mean I'm doing a good job. And numbers that are far away from zero mean I probably missed that one. Generally speaking, if predicted Setosa is over 0.5, then it's probably going to be Setosa. And if it's under 0.5, it's probably not going to be Setosa. So I'm actually looking for cases where my error rate is greater than 5 or less than minus 5, minus 0.5. Greater than 0.5 or less than minus 0.5, those are the misses. And everything that's sort of between minus 0.5 and positive 0.5, those are correct. So if we actually look at these values, we see that they're actually all under 0.5 and greater than minus 0.5. So they're all hits. And then you can also look at a histogram of that. So like SNS dot, what is it? Displot. And then I think I want type as hist. Well, so this shows us the distribution. We see that almost all of our predictions were somewhere between minus 0.2 and positive 0.1, say 1.8, 1.9. So within this range here, most of our predictions were in this range, which are well within the margin for error for predicting Setosa. Now, if we take one that didn't work very well, let's go ahead and do that. Let's take a look at our prediction for Versacolor, which we know is hard. So predicted Versacolor versus all predict of species Versacolor. Yeah, so 0.5 is right around here. So we got some fraction of this pretty big bar, and like all of these were wrong. And then 0.5 is right here, so a big portion of this bar were wrong as well. And then the whole shape is just sort of flat and spread out. So this means we're probably not doing a very good job of classifying versicolors, which is as expected. So good job at Setosa, 100% accuracy. Not such a good job on versicolor. I'm going to say probably this is maybe 70% or so, just sort of eyeballing this, but I'd have to actually do the math to figure it out. And then let's go ahead and do one more for Virginica. And so we expect our Virginica classification to be pretty good. It is for the most part. So this is under minus, or this is more than minus 0.5. So we came close, but we didn't get any wrong on this end. This 0.5 is right about halfway through this bar. So basically we got about half of this bar wrong, but there's only two cases in this bar. So basically we got one of these wrong and one of these right. So bottom line is, on all of the Virginicas, we got them all right except for one. So one out of 30 we got wrong. And then this one, actually, so this is going to be three cases here that we got wrong, and about half of this bar, so another four or five cases. And then on this side, we got maybe two more total. So like 7 out of 30 wrong, so not very good. 100%, like 70%, give or take, and pretty good, maybe 95%.